no time to think.
Just beat him.
Thank you.
You're too fat, get out of my way.
Ooh, they look scary.
Oh, he's gone.
So don't pick any more fights.
Trying to evolve as an Intellikea.
It looks like he's suffering.
Baul, come on.
You can do it.
No. I want to heal your wounds, but there's nothing I can do. My power is poison to you, isn't it?
Healing wounds isn't your power, Estelle.
What do you mean? Don't you remember Belius's words?
Power corrupts. But you are different. Never lose that kindness, the compassion you so readily show to others.
My compassion for others? Your thoughts are reaching Baul, I'm sure of it.
All we can do now is hope for the best. Well now.
Amazing!
I knew you could do it.
Your partner seems like he's gonna be just fine.
Yes. Thank you all for helping to protect him. This is something I couldn't have done alone.
You're one of us! Of course we'd help!
That's right!
What is she, the elf? Big boy right there.
Didn't I tell you? You got through to him. You make it through to Pharaoh as well. Will you be going to meet him?
That's up to Estelle to decide.
I'll go. It's been the purpose of my journey, after all.
Are you sure? What if you end up getting killed?
Even still, I've got to stand firm on this.
It won't be too long before the Hunting Blades send reinforcements. How about a change in scenery before they show up and spoil the party?
There's only one path down from here, though. We're bound to run into them.
The skies are wide open above us.
Have you lost your mind?
Get on. We'll fly as far as the Fyrtia. We can finish talking once we arrive.
Judy!
She's sleeping. She must be exhausted.
Yeah, I mean, she just keeled over. Wasn't expecting that.
I bet she watched over Baul the entire time he was evolving. She probably didn't get much sleep. She probably had no idea when the Hunting Blades would attack either.
She was putting up a brave front, but she must have been near the end of her rope.
She's just dumb. She doesn't know how to express what she's feeling.
And I'm really glad we're able to help Judy out.
We can finish talking with her tomorrow. We should let her sleep now. In fact, I wouldn't mind a little shut-eye myself. We still haven't heard Judy's side, so we can't say anything, but she sure caused the Guild a major headache, breaking Blastia's all on her own. There's no getting around that fact, no matter what her reasons. We have to settle this. Man, I hate waiting.
Are you thinking about Judy?
Yeah. I'm wondering what we should do about her.
It's true that she broke the Guild's laws and betrayed us.
I always thought that a Guild's strict adherence to its own laws was what kept it together. That there could be no exceptions, no lenience for those who would break the laws, but...
She did what she did to save the world. Judy is destroying Blastia because she knows it's the right thing to do, even if it makes people hate her.
Yep. Judith didn't break our laws in order to do something bad. I know this now. I'm gonna talk with her about it and give it some more thought. I'll figure this out eventually.
Oh yeah?
Maybe if I become a little more decisive, Nan will listen to me too.
Don't fall overboard.
Oh, I'll be careful. Yuri, the world sure is big.
Yeah. Even though we're flying this high in the air, we still can't see everything.
If the world's this big, I guess it makes sense that there'd be so many things we don't know. It might not make that much of a difference whether I get my memories back or not.
Are you saying you'd be okay with not getting them back?
I'm saying that I'm not the only one who feels restless and anxious not knowing the truth. Everyone's worried about something. Even you and Estelle.
You think so?
Isn't that why everyone's here? Isn't that why Judy came back?
Here?
And is that why you're here too?
I don't want to be alone.
You know, you're being pretty honest today.
I'm always honest.
Really? Well, maybe you are.
So does an old man past his prime fit into the picture at all?
What are you whining about, old man? Why are you past your prime?
What Judith was talking about before, Hermes Blastia, was it? Blastia created with techniques that should have been lost in the war are still active. Do you know what this means?
I guess someone who survived the war brought either Blastia or those techniques back with them.
If that person was still using the Blastia, even though he knew it was harmful to the Earth, someone like that would have to be quite the villain indeed.
Old man, don't tell me you...
Hey now, yours truly was nothing but an innocent youth on the straight and narrow back then. I wouldn't do something like that even on my worst day.
I was just trying to trick you into giving yourself away. A slippery one.
Son of a... When are you gonna learn some respect for your elders?
Got him.
Yuri.
Sorry to interrupt while you were thinking.
Ever since I took Bellius's life without meaning to, I've wanted to know what it means to be the child of the full moon, so the same thing doesn't happen again. I've always thought that it was my duty to know, but after what happened to Bellius...
That's how everyone is. They do something, they learn. They do something else, they learn more.
You too, Yuri?
Yeah.
Maybe if I had known everything ahead of time, I wouldn't have made any mistakes.
There's only one thing I can say for sure.
What's that?
Maybe you wouldn't have made any mistakes, but it sure would have been boring.
I really wonder.
Is that the core from the Ceres Blastia that Judy destroyed?
Yes, it's definitely cut with a different formula than a usual core. It looks like what she said was true.
She said she wasn't too good at lying, after all.
To discover that the new technique you created was bad for the world, after what must have been years of research. I can't imagine how the person who created the Hermes technique must have felt.
Well, what if it had been you?
If I found out that it hurt the Earth, I would have to do something about it. But I wouldn't destroy the Blastia like that.
What the?
Nothing. If only things weren't so complicated. I could have just blasted her into oblivion and been done with it.
Morning, Yuri.
Morning.
It's a beautiful morning, but even as we stand here, the air is out of balance, and our world may already be dying.
That's right.
Judy!
Well, look who's feeling better.
In the past, these slight fluctuations of the air have not negatively affected our world. There have always been beings who maintain the balance by sensing changes in the airflow. Beings like Pharaoh and Ba'ul, the Entelecheia.
So the Entelecheia were responsible for keeping the air balanced.
For ages, the Entelecheia have regulated the air, but the recent increase has been greater than they could control.
Which is being caused by the Hermes Blastia.
And which is also why you were going around taking down as many of them as you could.
Yes, that was my mission. The path I walk with Ba'ul, to whom I owe my life.
The path you walk?
Now some would even hunt the Entelechea for Apatheia. This has made the mission of the Entelechea even more difficult.
Why is everybody so crazy about these Apatheia anyway?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer. The air an Entelechea absorbs becomes condensed within its body over time. When its life is at an end, that condensed air forms a crystal, an Apatheia. That's all I know. I imagine Pharaoh could shed more light on the subject, though.
So Apatheia are crystals of concentrated air. If that's true and the energy could be extracted from the Apatheia, it would be a source of overwhelming power, I'm sure.
Could we really do that?
I don't know.
But if that's possible, there must be tons of guys who want those things.
I bet somebody wants to use these things for the wrong reasons.
Why didn't you just tell us all this from the beginning?
Seriously, we could have avoided all this trouble if you just talked to us. Am I wrong?
Even if you had known, there are things not even you could have prevented.
What do you mean?
I showed up at Heliord because Ba'ul had sensed a disturbance in the air. Where there was a disturbance, there was sure to be a Hermes Blastia. But what I found there was not a Blastia. It was a person. That had never happened before.
So it wasn't like you were looking for Estelle in particular back at Heliord.
Yet for some reason, Ba'ul perceived Estelle as a disturbance in the air. I had to find out why. For the sake of the path I've chosen. It was at that time that Pharaoh first appeared. He seemed to have some idea who Estelle was. My mission was to destroy all the Hermes Blastia. However, Estelle was obviously not a Blastia. I needed to make absolutely certain. I made a deal with Pharaoh, and he agreed to grant me some time.
You mean...
If it became apparent that her existence posed too great a threat, then I would kill her.
You what?
Wait, Rita!
Settle down. Obviously, Judith reached a different conclusion.
All right, I get it.
Bellius said you possess a heart of compassion. If you can communicate that to Pharaoh somehow, you may learn what you should do.
Hey, there's no real reason for you to fight Pharaoh anymore, right? I mean, we know the Hermes Blastia are what's causing the problem and everything. If we just make sure the Apatheia don't fall into the wrong hands...
I still want to meet Pharaoh. I want to hear what he has to tell me.
But...
Please try to understand. I have to know more about myself, and take responsibility for who I am.
All right.
Sorry, Yuri. I don't think we can decide what to do about Judith right away.
I promise not to leave again until things have been settled, as you said. I need to accept that responsibility myself.
Let's go and find Pharaoh. We'll finally be getting around to one of the first things we set out to do.
But not before a bunch of side quests.
We can work out the rest once this is finished.
There is a rocky crag in the center of the sands of Kogor. That is where Pharaoh lives. Ba'ul can take us there.
Okay, let's go. This meeting's been a long time coming.
I can communicate with Ba'ul, but there are still a few things you should know.
Like what?
Ba'ul can only land on the ground in wide, open spaces, so you won't be able to dismount on steep mountain ranges or in narrow canyons.
Can't he land on water?
Water's no good either.
Really? He looks like he'd be a good swimmer.
Yeah, he'd sink like a rock.
Huh, who knew?
But that's why we have a ship, right?
Right. If you'd like to get down onto the ocean, let me know. Ba'ul will set our ship down there for us.
Okay, but what should we do when we want to fly again?
Use Ba'ul's horn to call him to you.
Ba'ul's? That's all there is to it?
Every Entelechea has a special region in its brain that can be used for communication with a special power Kryptians possess.
Huh. So we can get a hold of him by using that.
Right.
Fly around.
Judith, you're familiar with Pharaoh, aren't you?
Is he really as scary as he seems?
Well, let's see. Sometimes he's logical, sometimes he's emotional. He can be really scary or really kind.
All right, that didn't help very much.
One thing's certain, his power's extraordinary, even among the Entelechea.
Here's hoping we don't wind up looking like poor old Mount Temsa the moment we meet him.
If he can do that to a mountain, there wouldn't be anything left if he turned on us.
I wish you wouldn't joke about scary things like that.
Why should we get scared before we even get there? Especially if he's that strong.
Wish I could take it as lightly as you and Yuri.
Nah, it's fine. That was here. Let's see. Okay. Alright.
I never imagined you'd be able to speak with the Entelechea.
Well, I use a Kritian technique to do it. Wait, do I detect a little jealousy?
Maybe. Right, Rapide?
Yuri, you want to talk to Rapide?
I think the two of you understand each other well enough already.
I got him pretty well figured out, but I don't know if he understands me.
I think he feels the same way.
Good old Rapide. That's not the word I'd use, damn, got him. Go here yet? I guess I didn't get these items. I could have gotten those a while ago.
We should really enjoy these little times together. That was too short.
There's an enemy. There is something.
Hold still. I'll make this quick.
All my heart. Baby, all my love. Who's that? Cerberus Blast!
Oh, blade of the best. I got
got no time to think.
No, there's nothing down there. The fastest is just backing up. He's like, no, I ain't paying part of this.
That's what happens when I get.
What are you?
Who are you paying your respects to?
An old friend. A dear comrade who shared my cause and gave his life in battle.
Battle? Was he in a guild?
Why would you think so?
Well, Imperial knights who fall in the line of duty are given a state funeral.
This has nothing to do with the Empire or the guilds.
What's that supposed to mean?
Those institutions are nothing more than man-made trivialities.
Is he the reason you've been drifting around so long?
That is none of your concern.
Hey, no need to get testy.
Just whose grave is this anyway?
It's not a knight or somebody from a guild. That's gotta mean...
I know some people can't afford a burial, but why put them in a place like this?
Estelle, what are you doing?
We may not know whose grave this is, but this feels like the right thing to do.
Might as well. Okay, let's head back down. I think we're done here.
Damn it.
Let's eliminate them.
That was a nice little break.
That's what happens when I get serious.
Yeah, I guess we'll fight.
So is that okay?
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
Pharaoh, Belius, Raoul? What sort of beings are Entelechea anyway?
They are the oldest intelligent life forms on Terpalumerase.
So, they aren't monsters?
They aren't. It's said that they have a higher level of awareness than humans, though they don't have a civilization.
Shiver me timbers! The Entelechea were smart!
The reports we get from Baul are pretty accurate.
He's a smart boy.
The language is like a cat just ran across the keyboard. Oh yeah, she looked at these. I'd probably be able to get that. have that. Yo, what's up, babe? How you doing? Also, I forgot to undo this. There we go. Can't hear anything? Like, no audio whatsoever? I mean, if you can't hear anything, then you wouldn't be able to hear me say that, I guess. Does it work now? Alright, so let's see, there's a bunch of stuff here. Okay. Alright. Success? Excellent. Monster book, 32%, so neither of those are going to do. Hey Niku, what's happening, dude? You just got home? And you can't decide? Can't decide on what? freaking Raven, dude. Think you're gonna go with sleeping? What up, chicken? We have that emote. That FFZ emote. We have that. Let's go. It's a lot warmer today, being home, because it makes me want to nap so hard. I am looking forward to having warmer weather. Which, it's still not really warmer yet here, but it's getting there. Which is good. These cold drinks also look so good, and there it is. Yo, what's up, Shadow? How's it going? So that he just overdoes it for you. Feels bad, man. Say I didn't try it for anything else. Thank you.
We delivered the book, just like you asked. Here, look. This is proof we finished the job.
Oh, indeed. That's Novus is all right. Wow, thanks so much for your help. And here is the pay I promised you.
If you ever need anything else, don't hesitate to call on Brave Vesperia.
Yes, of course. See you later.
A symbol of their friendship. How touching. I wonder what kind of book it was.
It was just a normal book. Looked like it had something to do with economics.
Did you look inside, Raven?
So what if I did?
I mean, it's fine, but what if the client had hidden something private in the book?
Oh, it's no big deal. No harm done if it didn't get in the way of the job.
An economics book, huh? That didn't sound too racy.
It would have been funny if some romance novel was the proof of two guys' friendship.
Really?
Anyway, I guess we're done with our first job with the Union.
So this is what it's like to work in a guild.
Yeah. If we were the Hunting Blades, we'd probably get jobs to exterminate monsters. Fortune's Market usually does stuff like transport products over long distances.
So, Brave Vesperia is in the delivery business then?
Well, we...
We can think it over while we try out a few different kinds of work.
Yeah, sure.
He's naked, Monka. Pheromone boy. Isn't there where we got that milk from? Yep, that's where we got the milk from. And apparently, not only is that where we got the milk from, apparently he's also naked. So, it's even worse. You thought Yuri was gonna kill those kids, but then he didn't. Feels bad, man. Got him. Just a little collateral damage. Awkward. You wouldn't carry around a picture of her if she wasn't important. Ooh, got him. Oh, pfft. Try to talk to a log and a thing attack.
Can you be any weaker? Let's just get it over with.
I feel like when Noah's still feels bad, man.
Don't scare me.
Wait, hold on. I really want no fun. Feels super bad, man. Yeah, here comes a new spell. Uses not a spell. Good job, Rita.
Let's go.
Oh, I missed.
You got anything up there?
P-brain peon. The same guy's name on it. You really think Jaeger and Reggae are the same guy? The person whose name spelled backwards is the other guy's name? You think they're the same person? What? Nah. You have all these weapons, don't you? What if they're actually Zelda? Oh, you're right. Okay. So that'd be the last side quest stuff to do. Got some stuff to take care of in Dondurus, and then we'll be back to the main storyline. It's up there. It's more north than I thought it was. Hey. Looks like I walked into the wrong building by accident. See ya. This is not actually what I'm meant to do right now.
Good fish.
Can I talk to this guy? Maybe. Spirit Parfait. Definitely not doing this right now though. If I can do it later. Getting kind of creepy, old man. Who got into you? He's gone. That would explain why it's so quiet. Got him. Two barks. Specifically, two barks. Thank you for the input repeat. Aggressive bark. Repeat and use very helpful dialogue. dash. I already have one, so I'll just talk to her again. Get owned, idiot. Big growl.
Big growl.
Here it is, darling. Your very own Everlight necklace.
Oh my gosh, thank you so much. Where did you ever find it?
That's definitely also Laura Bailey.
Well, you see...
Oh wow, what a miracle. Thank goodness. Now for your reward.
Oh, your love is reward enough.
Settle down, old man.
Rihanna!
You! Where have you been?
You're that man from Heliord.
Hey, you! Rihanna, how do you know these people?
They were looking for my necklace.
What? Oh, so that's why you were...
That's right. So who the hell are you?
I'm an old friend of hers.
An old friend, huh?
You know, you are really annoying. Could you just shut up for a minute, please?
All right, I can take a hint.
Where were you all this time? I've been looking for you.
I've been out looking for your necklace. The necklace that you said was a memento of your father, but I couldn't find it.
Don't worry. There's a reason that I wanted to find it myself. In the end, I had to get some help from these people, but... I wanted to be the one to give you this, as a symbol of our engagement.
Huh? Engagement?
You did that for me?
I think we should be on our way.
Oh? But what about our payment?
Consider it a wedding present, right, Kyo?
He's gone. Huh? He was right here a moment ago.
Think you might have just landed Mido Skiff? Hey, nice, let's go.
Maybe something came up again. Hey, old man, let's go.
Huh? Oh, right.
Are you done? Sorry, I remembered I had to do something. So did you get the payment?
Nah, no payment this time.
What? What are you talking about? How can you not take payment for a guild job?
Let's just say this job was a wedding present.
A wedding present? Huh? You mean Professor Rihanna is...
Professor?
You did say that you knew her from a guild you used to be in.
Actually, she was sort of my teacher in the guild. She was famous for being really strict. I know I got my share of beatings.
Hmm. So that's why you didn't come with us to meet her. Well, no biggie.
No biggie? Yes, biggie! You didn't get a payment!
Yes, biggie!
There's something besides payment that I'd like to settle.
Huh? What do you mean, Judith?
So far we've delivered stuff and found stuff. Two totally different kinds of work. What is Brave Asperia for? What does this guild I belong to do?
She's got a point. What are you doing all this for? Money? You like doing it? Looking at it from the outside? I can't tell what you want to do. I mean, I'm not a member or anything, so whatever.
Okay, let's just say this is the trial period while we're figuring that out.
Huh? Yeah, okay.
If we can't come up with an answer right now, we'll just think on it for a while.
Aggressive bark.
Right.
Randomize your duty with Aaron Tizzy. You're all stuck. None of us have Sarius or Minuet. At least now you can get a forest, yeah, if you got a. If you figured out how to do Mito Skip. Do you have a. I don't know if there's like more than one way to do it, but. Do you have. You have Hookshot already? Aggressive bark.
Aggressive bark.
Y'all have Hookshot? Awesome. This 40s Gold Chills. Oh yeah, I think you told me that. Yeah, and Sun Song was 30. Yeah, okay, I remember now. You did tell me that. Let me check out Kato's. See if I can get some more water. So I think that's what I need. But that's the end of all the side quests for now. Wrong way. Alright, let's check here. Show off your knowledge, show them they weren't going for sculptures, you just kept going. You're just thinking tokens, yeah. 39, 40, 42, 45. Yep. You could go away to like 60. Nice. They're at like 17, 20, yeah. I don't think the enemies that I'm looking for are here.
We'll destroy them in no time.
Slower, but yeah, Skullchillas can be really nice. I usually try to do like that kind of stuff all at once as well.
I feel like an easy win.
Don't get careless.
Oh, I missed.
I got no time to think.
I don't think this is the right place. Wartha. It's a secret to everybody. Nope, I did not get the thing I was looking for.
You'll be gone soon enough.
On the enemies.
Oh, there's no challenge at all.
I guess I'll go easy on them.
Let's go.
Still, I'll make this quick. Here.
What was that? Ew.
You'll be gone soon enough.
Didn't quite get him, Harry.
Was I a little hard on you?
I don't know if I'm gonna find any. probably fine.
This will make good practice.
Let's just get it over with.
And again! Brilliant! This! And again!
To be!
Cerberus Blast!
Oh, I missed.
We're done.
I don't even know if they do drop it. I hope they do. Maybe it's really rare. Oh, I guess those don't drop it. I don't know why I said that they did then. Actually, I'll just stop here real quick.
So this is where Pharaoh is?
Should be. I wasn't able to see him when we came to the desert, but I think this is where we can meet him.
I hope nothing bad will happen. What if he suddenly attacks us?
I can't make any guarantees. I don't think we'll have a say in the matter.
That just means we need to do our best so nothing bad happens.
Carol, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay. I should go.
Pharaoh sure did pick a bleak place to live in, don't you think?
They say this area used to be covered in lush greenery.
Why did it turn into this rocky desert?
I don't know that much.
Estelle, are you really going to meet him, even though you could be killed?
Yes, I've already made peace with this decision.
Rita, you've been acting a little funny ever since hearing Judy's story on the ship. Do you have a problem with meeting Pharaoh?
I just think it'll be hard on her to hear what he has to say, but it's too late to turn back now. We've come this far after all.
Somewhere taking a nap.
Pharaoh, you are here, aren't you?
Insipid poison. You appear before me at last.
So you are here. Is that how you greet all your guests, Pharaoh? By calling them names?
For what reason have you come to me? Surely you are aware that I could end your existence with a mere thought.
You talk pretty big, don't you? Well, if you really want to fight, I'd hate to disappoint you.
Yuri, no! Everyone!
one. Please wait. Estelle! Pharaoh, please hear what I have to say.
Does death hold no fear for you, little one? For you gaze now into the mouth of death itself.
I am afraid, but I'm even more afraid of dying without knowing who I really am. Bellius told me I needed to meet you to learn about my destiny. I have to know just what that destiny is. I understand that I am a threat to the Entelechea, but you said that I am a poison to this world. What is this power I have? Just who is the child of the full moon? If it is true that my existence cannot be tolerated, then it's okay if I have to die. But I at least deserve to know why it is I have to die. Please tell me. I beg of you.
There was a time when this was a verdant land, sheltered by the blessing of an Heir Krenne.
So there was an Heir Krenne here. But what happened? Why did it change?
What you see are the results of too much air and its aftermath. As to why the air ran rampant, the answer lies with the poison brought by the Child of the Full Moon.
Huh?
The power of the Child of the Full Moon stimulates the Heir Krenne more than any Blastia.
Huh?
Blastia convert air into energy by way of a formula.
Huh?
So if Estelle can use her healing arts without the aid of any Blastia, she must possess a formula in her very being that lets her convert air into energy. Judith was searching for Blastia that used a particular kind of formula. So, this special formula Estelle has must also consume massive amounts of air, which causes the Heir Krenne to become more active and pump out more air than they should. I had hoped my hypothesis would have been wrong.
Then,
It is as she has said, with each use of her power, the Child of the Full Moon uses far more air than the Blastia. In so doing, the imbalance of air in this world is furthered. For the planet, such an existence can only be called a poison.
So you just wipe it out then? Little quick to judge, aren't you, Pharaoh?
This problem concerns the entire planet, and she is its cause. To do nothing would be unparalleled folly.
If the problem's with Estelle, then it's for us to solve.
That's right. We can't let anyone else handle it.
The gravity of this situation is beyond your grasp.
You don't honestly think that everything's gonna be all sunshine and rainbows if Estelle dies, do you?
It would at least eliminate one problem.
Pharaoh, at Heliord I stopped myself. And again at Dawngrest I stopped you. What I thought was a Blastia turned out to be a human. Before I realized it, I had lost my way. I never thought this child could be as great a danger as you had said.
And due to your confusion, I granted you the time necessary to see things as they are. As a result, my sister Bellius is now lost to me. Enough. This power will bring only ruin.
Not sure I understand all this, but if her power's the problem, why can't she just not use it?
There can be no guarantee she will not try to use the power.
That's true. She does have trouble turning a blind eye to things happening around her. Someday she will surely use her power to help someone. However, as long as she keeps that spirit of compassion, she cannot only be seen as harmful. She is not like a Blastia. I know that you can feel the difference.
Compassion alone will not save this world.
Listen, Pharaoh. I get that you've thought all this through with everybody's best interest in mind, but why doesn't that world have a place for Estelle?
It is sometimes necessary to remove a part to save the whole.
I don't buy that for a second. What makes you so high and mighty that you're the one to decide who gets cut and who doesn't?
We have endured the anxiety of existence for far greater a span than you can conceive. Such words mean nothing from those who call this world home for but a fleeting moment.
Pharaoh, please, listen. The important thing is finding a way to stop the excessive air, correct? We still have time left to search for such a thing.
Judith!
And if... if the effects of Estelle's power reach their absolute limit, I will kill her as promised. You should have no complaint with this.
Hey, Judith, are you serious?
I'm sure brave Vesperia will come up with something before that happens, right?
What? Yeah, of course we will.
Score one for Judith, so that settles it. If we humans are to blame for Estelle's problem and bringing on the apocalypse, then it's up to us to make things right. If we give it all we've got and still blow it, you can slow roast us on a grill for all I care.
You have changed. If you were still as before.
Have I? That is nice to hear.
Very well. Be ever mindful, though, that time is fleeting.
Wait! If the formulas are causing the excessive air, then there must have been times when this happened in the past. I mean, the Blastia were a product of an ancient civilization.
There exist those who have inherited the sins of the past. If any yet can speak of what occurred in the days of old, it is they.
He's gone!
Bye-bye!
Thanks for everything, Yuri. Judith, you too.
No problem. But hey.
What?
It's okay if I have to die? What the hell was that?
I'm sorry.
I don't want to hear that again.
I'm sorry.
Man, I was really worried there for a while.
Welcome back, babe. How's it going?
We were pretty lucky that Bruiser was in a mood for conversation. Poor Raven's heart can't handle that sort of stuff anymore.
You're pretty gutless for an old man.
Jeez, Patty, you've really got nerves of steel.
If he really wanted to kill Estelle, he'd have attacked us immediately. And that's what I can't figure out.
I imagine Pharaoh was conflicted as well. He hid himself from us in the desert to see just what we were made of.
Huh. Maybe he wasn't as bad as we thought after all.
You might be right. I get the feeling he'd do whatever's necessary when push comes to shove.
That sounds like you.
Maybe.
But what are we gonna do, Yuri?
Maybe.
You heard what he said.
We're going to fix the problems the air's causing. And that's all.
That's easier said than done. We're pretty much at square one, you know.
Mm-hmm. And no one wants to be at square one.
There's no doubt that the formulas are related somehow to the air getting used up.
Yeah, I put a cat on her head. It's pretty great.
We need to find out about the ancient Blastia, and if they went berserk or not. If we had that kind of information, it might give us a clue.
Also, I just realized just now, if you look in the bottom left corner, you can see the stuffed Raven doll that's on her feed. He's got his mouth open, like he's being hit in the back or something. He's like, whoa.
Ask those who have inherited the sins of the past about the days of old. Or at least that's what Pharaoh said. The Critia were the ones to invent the Blastia. In other words, we need to ask a Critian who is still familiar with the old stories.
Yeah, the Critia are often credited as the inventors of the Blastia.
There isn't much left of the Critian city of Timsa, though.
It'd be a lot easier if there were more cities.
The hidden city of Miorzo. It is far older than Timsa, and the birthplace of the Critia. The first Blastia also originated there.
Really? Well, what do you know? You wouldn't happen to know where this Miorzo might be, would you, darling?
Babe number two. Let's go.
I've heard that name somewhere. There was a Critian in Ospio. I'm sure they mentioned something about it.
Do you think that person might still be there?
Well, there's no harm in checking it out.
Judith, are you coming with us?
I should. We still have the issue of the guild to straighten out.
So, to Ospio, then.
The emotes return.
Now that you kids have gotten an insight into the real Raven, I think it's your turn.
Our turn to what?
To tell about your love lives. What else?
You're so stupid.
I'd kind of like to hear what everyone has to say. Oh? Then you have to start, Estelle. What's your ideal man like?
My ideal man is someone like the Amber Knight in the Tale of the Jade Planet.
Who?
In the Tale of the Jade Planet, he's a good friend of the main character and...
Sure, who's next?
I prefer a girl who's nice, a little quiet, maybe kind of gentle, not too tall.
That girl you liked, was she like that?
I seem to remember her being a bit more on the strong-willed side.
Rita and Judith, what about you?
Someone who's not like the old man.
That sounds about right.
Yeah, I'll go with that too.
You kids just don't understand the beauty
got him.
Of a middle-aged man. Someday.
Got him. It's so obvious she means Flynn. Well, basically, she... The character she describes is basically Guy from Tales of the Abyss, who is basically Flynn. So yes, she is basically talking about Flynn. Gary likes guys? What? Oh wait, I have magic lens through it. Didn't mean to jump there. Hoo-ah! You want to keep Fudgy vaulting.
Let's go.
Best friend of the main character. Hmm, who could that be? Yeah. No, it's exactly Guy. It's Guy. Enter the amazing guy. What is on repeat? Everything. Everything is on repeat. Look how Raven's like surfing. And Carol's just hanging on.
About the balance of the world is pretty hard to take in.
Yeah, I hadn't even been outside the capital until just a while ago myself. And now we're here talking about the fate of the world. You never know what life will bring you.
But isn't that what makes it interesting? I don't think we can afford to be that relaxed anymore. Estelle doesn't have much time left.
What's the harm? It's not as if acting all serious is gonna solve anything.
Besides, Estelle will notice if we look all worried.
Well, maybe so, but...
We won't forget what Pharaoh said. Relax.
I know, it's just...
Estelle's got it the worst. If we get too down about this, we won't be much help to her.
been another long day. Let's save the manhunt for tomorrow.
I second that. How long's it been since I've slept in a proper bed?
Well, I suppose we can all stay at my place.
Wait, there's something I want to take care of first.
You mean me?
Carol.
This is a guild thing. Best for us not to get involved.
I've thought about it a lot. What we should do, like, as a guild. And I realized, we have to figure out a few things if we're gonna keep this guild going.
It sounds like you've decided what we should do.
Well, we said it before. The most important thing is obeying the guild's laws. Those who break the laws suffer strict punishment, even if they're friends or family. They say that's the source of a guild's pride.
Yes.
So what I'm thinking is, we all have to receive punishment.
What do you mean?
I didn't know that Judith was fighting for our planet all on her own. But even though I didn't know, I still failed to help a fellow guild member.
Egg bears, let's go.
So I gotta accept my punishment. Eerie?
Me?
Maybe you were trying to follow your own path, but you still kept things hidden from us. There's no way that can be for the good of the guild.
Well...
So you gotta be punished too.
Now he's stretching it.
The laws are important. What if someone does the right thing, but still breaks the law? Should they be punished? To be honest, I just don't know yet. So that's why we should all just accept our punishment and start over from scratch. What do you think?
I can't promise I won't have my secrets in the future.
Well, if that's the way it is, if you can't trust us, then there's nothing you can do. That would be my fault.
And what if I destroy a Blastia that our guild was planning on using again? That would be breaking the law that says I should act in the interest of the guild.
But you'd also be acting for the sake of the world. Guilds aren't there just so people can obey their laws. I think we can let that slide.
Doesn't that sort of make your laws meaningless?
I've never heard of a guild like this before, but you've got me interested, I'll give you that much.
There's no need to be such a stickler for the rules. Gotta be more relaxed.
Carol, you're just full of surprises. I thought plenty about myself and what I should be doing, but I might not have considered how my actions would affect you guys. This is a way of settling things I didn't even realize existed.
I just wanted to keep traveling with all of you. I just wanted each of our own paths to be the same as Brave Asparius.
Sounds all right with me. You heard the man, Judy. I guess that's where we stand.
You really are some of the oddest people I've ever met. But...
Character development, yep.
I suppose I can manage to put up with you.
All right then, one more time. Brave Vesperia, fall out!
They're just making it up as they go, aren't they? Is that all a guild is?
The Don ran his guild just a teensy bit differently.
There's something beautiful about this way, though.
Brave Vesperia sure is nice.
Do you want to join too, Patty?
Can't right now.
Oh yeah. You still have to get your memory back.
So, what about the punishment?
Oh yeah, I almost forgot.
Looks like you guys are on Critian researcher detail. We'll be relaxing at my place.
Hey, why do you get to decide?
Excuse me? Did I hear a complaint?
No, ma'am.
No.
Carol, were you thinking by yourself this whole time about what to do with Judy?
Yeah, it was pretty much all I thought about after we left Nordopolica. That, and about what you did to Rago and Kumor.
Really? It's nice to hear you thought about me that much, even when I wasn't around.
Yeah, I wasn't sure at first, what was right, what was wrong. I think I have the Dawn to thank for setting me straight. Without the Dawn's last words, I never would have found answers to the questions I had.
You gotta stand on your own two feet.
Yeah, I was thinking about what that meant. And before I knew it, I wasn't thinking about what was right. I was thinking about what I want to do.
And that helped you decide what to do with the guild.
Yeah, so here's to fresh starts.
Yeah.
To fresh starts.
this is different than the 360 version. All right, then. I don't remember this in the PC version either, but maybe it was.
You're searching for Mirzo? That's the name of the city that they talk about in the Cridian legends. That's all I know.
I like how a dog walks up to this guy, and he's just like, oh, you're searching for the city of Mirzo. Clearly, I can tell that. And Rafi's just like, aggressive bark. He's talking to a dog.
Location. I don't know where it is. And even if I knew,
I'll never tell.
I don't think it will be of any good to tell it to someone other than a Cridian.
I think I have to talk to Miss Judith. Yeah, I have to talk to Miss Judith.
Good day.
Good day, my sister.
Judith.
I'm Tort.
You wouldn't happen to know anything about Mirzo, would you? I'd like to go there. I need to know where Mirzo is located and how I can get there.
Even if you reach the city, there won't be anything for you to see there. But what do you plan on doing there anyway?
Is not a Cridian's interest in her own ancestral city reason enough to go?
That is an acceptable reason, but I'm afraid I don't know anything about where it could be.
I've heard your name before, Tort. You help guide those Cridians remaining on Earth up to the heavens. Will you not tell me because these humans are with me?
Our ancient law states that we cannot show anyone but our brothers and sisters the way to Mirzo.
Shouldn't it be a matter of whether they can be trusted rather than whether they're Cridian or not? At the very least, these humans can be trusted.
I shall ask once more, why do you seek Mirzo?
The world is headed toward some bad things, all thanks to Blastia. We want to go to know what happened in the past and how we can stop it. We want to help everyone, not just the Cridians. How's that?
Very well. I do not know if you'll find the answers to your questions, but I will show you the way. First of all, you'll need a special bell to open the path to Mirzo.
A bell?
Indeed.
A bell?
It is hidden in one of the southern caverns on the continent of Hippionia.
But isn't Hippionia really big?
The cavern is on a shore where red flowers bloom. If you use that as your guide, I'm sure you shall find it. Also, the door in the back of that cavern can only be opened by us Cridians.
What do you mean?
Don't worry. I'll see that we're allowed to enter.
And? What are we supposed to do with that bell?
Relax. You humans are always so impatient. Once you have the bell, you must travel to Agathor Forest.
The Agathor Forest? Isn't that on Hippionia too? I've heard of it before.
Yes. The sacred land of the Cridians is located there, so that's where the door to Mirzo is.
If you use the bell there, the door shall open. There is, however, a problem.
A problem?
Yes. Agathor Forest is being devastated by a mysterious group. In addition to their overwhelming numbers, they also carry with them strange Blastia. I cannot fathom their motives, but this is certainly a matter of great concern.
So if we go to Mirzo, we have to do something about them?
Exactly. We need you to restore peace to our sacred land.
Gotcha. So we get that bell, beat the mysterious group senseless, ring the bell, and the door opens. That sound right?
Indeed.
I understand. Thank you.
May the road rise up to meet you, sister.
And you as well. Let's go back to where everyone's waiting.
Yeah.
That wasn't bad, Carol.
I have to say, I really didn't expect to hear that again. Come to think of it, Judy doesn't ask about that at all.
Oh, should I?
Would it be a problem? Well, even if you don't ask, the answer is still clear to you.
I'm not sure about that. Even so, you're still you, and I'm still me. If our paths are the same, I'll travel with you. If I didn't think they were, I wouldn't be here.
So everything is clear to you, see?
I'm pretty sure what I'm thinking is clear to you as well.
Is it something like people who choose the same path think alike?
Did you find out anything?
We've got a lead in a place called Agathor Forest.
I'm pretty sure it's on the west side of Hippionia, to the south of here.
So, Mirzo's in that forest?
No, but a door is.
Huh? A door?
What do you mean?
A door? And Estelle hears door, and she's like, a door? There's a door? Guys, we gotta go see the door. Come on. It's a door. Let's go, guys. We gotta see the door.
There's a door there that leads to Miorso.
We were told the bell that opens the door is hidden in a cavern on a shore in Hippionia, where red flowers bloom.
It'd be fastest to just go and check it out.
First, let me rest.
Perhaps we should get some rest before leaving?
But...
we don't really have a choice.
All right, then I'm gonna walk around town and search for clues about the treasure.
Hey, hold it. You should really... Hey, she's gone already.
Anyway, once we've gotten some rest, let's go look for that cavern in Hippionia.
So, Patty, did you find any clues about the Maristella?
There were a lot of books, but none of them were about Eifried.
Well, duh. This city only has books about Blastia.
Oh, well. Looks like I'm just gonna have to keep searching for clues with you guys.
Did you just say Eifried?
Huh?
Hey, you. You that girl they've been saying is Eifried's grandchild? So, you neither admit nor deny it. And I guess it must be true.
Carol looks so out of place there.
Interesting. So you're the grandchild of that bastard who disgraced the guilds. You just look like a regular brat to me. Why don't you say something? Can't even defend your own grandfather? Oh yeah, I guess that's something no one could ever defend, huh? Considering all the nasty stuff he did.
How can you say such horrible things?
How? Well, because it's the truth. Hey, wait! You guys must be Siren's Fang's newest guild members, right?
We're Brave Vesperia.
Brave Vesperia? What a funny name. What kind of a guild is that?
Well, it's, you see...
Why? You gonna give us some good jobs if we tell you?
I don't have any jobs to give shady thugs involved with Eifried like you guys. Brave Vesperia, huh? It's good for nothing trash like you who've been tarnishing what it means to be a guild.
You're the good for nothing trash who's been tarnishing the name of the city.
You're Rita Mordio?
Looks like there's a lot more vulgar pieces of trash than the last time I was here. Geez, it'll be a real nuisance if anyone thinks I'm associated with you. Let's get out of here.
Wait!
Oh? Was there something else you wanted to say?
No.
But what are we gonna do? I'm pretty sure that guy's gonna spread rumors.
I don't care. If that's the kind of thing that could destroy our guild, we would have been finished a long time ago.
Yeah, we should just let people say what they're going to say.
Wasn't our destination ashore in Hippionia where red flowers bloom?
Ah, yeah.
Then let's get going.
Thank you. I'll make good practice.
Don't get careless.
Flickering blades burn! This is it, right?
It matches the description Tort gave us, but...
A shore in Hippionia where red flowers bloom, right?
Maybe Tort tricked you guys.
Either that or we came to the wrong place.
Wait. I can feel a draft coming from in there.
The inside must be hollow.
Out of the way! It's open.
What kind of a nasty person does something like that?
Perhaps they sealed it up to keep fishy people like you from getting in.
Whoa! You're really gunning for old Raven? Sometimes you can be so mean, Judith.
What's wrong, Patty?
It's nothing. I was just a little scared of the dark.
You're scared of the dark? You really are a kid.
Look who's talking.
If you're scared, you can wait here.
I'm fine. I'll go with you guys.
Okay, so this is new. Okay.
just that.
It's a grave, y'all.
What are all these stones doing in a place like this? It's so creepy.
Wait, these aren't graves, are they?
Maybe we really did come to the wrong place.
But even if that's the case, why are there so many here? Why?
I can't believe how many there are.
I never imagined we'd find a place like this while we were searching for the home of the Crydia.
There's something written over there.
Here lie the victims of the Black Hope Massacre. We mourn their deaths, and in this place lay their souls to rest.
These are all victims of the Black Hope Massacre!
And these are the graves of people who were killed by Ifrit? Yes, but I had no idea there could be so many. Patty!
I never thought!
Patty!
No matter how you look at it, this is just too much. You can't expect a child to accept such a cold reality at her age.
I wonder who built these graves.
Who knows? Maybe there were some survivors of the massacre.
But this is so horrible.
I'm going to look for the key to Miorzo. You all should stay here.
What? You're going by yourself?
We can't bring Patty along when she's like this, can we?
There aren't any signs of monsters here. We should go too. Repeat, take good care of Patty, okay?
Woof.
Looks like a dead end.
Maybe the old man was right. We really did come to the wrong place.
There weren't any other shores with red flowers, were there?
Do you mind if I take a look at that? Illusion, be undone. It is I of the chosen people whom you have anxiously awaited.
A door? Estelle's getting excited, guys. A door? It's a door. Come on, we gotta go see the door, guys. It's a door.
What did you do?
The Crydians possess an ancient power known as the Nagig that can read the information in objects. I used that power to learn the secret phrase that would remove the enchantment that hid this door.
I see. So this is what Tort meant when he said the door could only be opened by a Crydian.
Now, let's go inside.
Could this be the key for the door to Miorzo?
Yes. We were told it's a bell, so this has to be it.
Still, why is there a graveyard in the cave where the bell was hidden?
It's just a coincidence.
Maybe. I bet the person who built that graveyard didn't know the bell was hidden here.
I guess that's to be expected with the door being invisible.
Maybe the person who closed the entrance to this cave was the one who built the graveyard.
What for?
Who knows? Maybe to prevent grave robbing. Or maybe there was some other reason they had to hide this place.
It is true that Tort never said anything about the cave entrance. You might be right.
So someone went to all the trouble of burying those people in such a remote location? Is that really all it is?
I don't know, but we've got the bell we came for, so let's go back and see Patty.
Yuri, did Ifrit really kill all those people?
Maybe he did.
Patty.
That's the truth she was after.
Yes, but she wasn't at all prepared for it.
Right. Let's hurry back.
Thank you. Woof.
Thank you, Rapide. We got what we came for.
Woof.
Can you stand up, Patty? We're going.
Are you going already?
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Don't push yourself, okay?
Cypher.
Can you come with us? Could she be? All we've got left to do is to ring the bell we just got in Agathor Forest.
I agree.
Yuri, I need to talk to you.
What is it?
I'd like to say goodbye to all of you now. It's time for us to part ways.
You sure?
Why so sudden? You don't like traveling with us anymore?
No, that's not it.
If you feel uncomfortable around us because of what you learned about Ifrid, then...
Just don't want to cause you guys any more trouble. Even if you don't mind. Well, I do.
Patty.
What kind of nonsense is that?
Rita?
Every single one of these guys causes nothing but trouble. Do you really think you're any more of a troublemaker than the rest of us?
Rita.
If it's really just so you can focus on what you need to do, then I won't try to stop you.
I...
It'll be lonely around here without you.
We've come this far together. There's no need to hold back.
We crossed the desert and fought so many battles together.
Besides, you don't need to give an answer here and now, do you?
Plus, if you leave us now, we won't be able to pilot the ship and we'll be in real trouble.
Why?
Just think about it after your emotions have calmed down. You can pick what you want to do then. Until that time, though, why don't you come with us?
Okay.
All right. It's off to Agathor Forest.
We just gotta get rid of those suspicious guys and ring the bell, right?
Yes.
Do you think Patty is all right?
Memories, knowledge of what the geezer did, forced to face reality. It'd discourage anyone.
She looks so miserable.
It's best to leave her alone for now.
Rapide. What's troubling you, Rapide? Rapide. The thing is...
Mooch is the best companion in times like these.
I hope that she can find some measure of peace this way.
This is Agathor Forest, a holy place for the Kryttian people.
nicer here than I imagined. Not a bad spot at all.
Whoa, really? I thought you liked being cooped up in cold, dark labs and stuff.
I wish I could have seen it in its original state.
That must be the Blastia the mystery group brought with them.
But that's a Hopelone Blastia.
What do you mean by mystery group?
We weren't able to get any details, but Tort said he'd tell us how to get to Murzo if we did something about them.
Would doing something include smashing that thing?
I wonder. I suppose we could if there are no complaints.
I'll fix it so there's no need for you to break it.
Oh? I'll leave it to you then.
Are you gonna rest on the ship?
No, I'll go.
So, is Murzo here?
I wonder. I get the feeling it won't be easy to find.
Nobody we talked to had even heard of a town called Murzo.
You'd expect to see more activity in this place if anybody knew there was a town here.
The difficulty of the road might be responsible for that, though.
Man, why'd the Critians have to go and build a town in a place like this anyway?
Probably to avoid a lot of prying eyes.
We're just gonna have to check it out for ourselves to make sure then.
Soon enough.
Nugget Hopper, let's go. Are you done already? I'm not done yet. Oh, okay. I guess that answers the question then.
We have to take them all out. We'll crush them up.
Muy.
I'm taking you down.
It's over. Yeah, I feel good.
Still, I'll make this quick.
This area is currently under control of the Imperial Knights.
The Royal Guard. This is the Commandant's private force of elite knights.
What are the Commandant's forces doing in a forest like this with Hopalon Blastia?
I've no reason to answer your questions. Civilian activity is restricted by law in this area.
Be that as it may, why are you pointing that weapon at us like that?
Bring it on!
That a great way to answer that question. No way!
That's over.
Finish that one.
Man, that escalated quickly. Well, we're off to a good start.
So the mysterious group of people was the Imperial Knights.
Why did he attack us?
Maybe because they're doing something here that they don't want anyone to know about?
You mean, with that Blastia?
Maybe, yeah.
You said you were gonna come with us, so you better pull yourself together.
I know. Watch out!
Estelle! What did you just do?
Same as what she did in Heliard. Estelle's power took the air and made it dissipate. You've got to stop doing crazy things like that. I'm sorry. I just thought about how everyone was in danger, and before I knew it, my power...
Her power is starting to unconsciously respond to her feelings.
That last attack came from that Blastia. It was aiming straight at us.
Which means that Estelle will end up using her power every time we're shot at.
But then, what should I do?
Hey, you saved us, didn't you?
Yeah, if that had hit us head on, we would have been goners for sure. We should be mad at the fact that they shot at us, not that Estelle protected us.
We've sworn to settle Estelle's problems along with the world's problems. Everything we're doing right now is towards that purpose. We shouldn't let the details get in our way.
But won't Pharaoh get mad if she keeps doing stuff like this? Whether it's by Ablastia or by Pharaoh, I don't want to be barbecued alive.
Come on, this is simple. We just have to do something about that Blastia, right?
That's right.
Let's pummel the jerks who are controlling that Blastia!
Alright, let's go. Try to keep a low profile. If you keep standing around, we're gonna leave you behind.
Stay close behind me, Estelle. My magic will protect you if they attack with the Hoplon Blastia.
But you'd be putting yourself in danger, Rita.
We're all in danger, so relax. Or maybe you don't believe I can do it.
No, no. I'm just worried about you.
Well, I'm worried about you.
Those two sure have come a long way.
Got him.
Their little fights were fun, though. Oh well, I guess this way is healthier for everyone.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Hey, Peanut Gallery! Shut up, or we'll leave you behind.
She's still got a couple of rough spots to work on, though.
Destroy them in no time.
Their TP sucks. Their TP is actually normal. Oh, that's not what I'm looking for. Also, how's it going, Kat? What was it? Oh, she can change weapons too, I forgot. So, Azure Edge, Shining Fang. Okay, just those two. Gotcha. Damn it, hit the wrong button. Well, Rita also her 165 is not her max. It's the amount she currently has. And she is at way less than half. So she has probably about 3 times as much TP as it currently looks like she does. And no, they're not level 24. We're actually higher than level 24. Like level 30-something. Finally get to get beat up again. Hey, nice.
I'm just getting started. Hooray for the old man!
Yeah, she has 510 TP normally, or her max is. No, Walls is good. That one I don't need. I forgot to turn her spells back on. Nice. Hooray for the old man, exactly.
Yeah, I guess we'll fight.
Nice, I missed.
This? No, this isn't scary.
Your legs are shaking.
You're kidding.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, I am. Where do I want to go first? I forget.
Hold still. I'll make this quick. Let's go.
Get ready. I'm taking you down.
You're going bye-bye.
I'm just getting started. Yeah, I feel good.
Okay, I don't want to be there yet. I think. Maybe? Okay, no, I guess I'm there. Oh, okay, so I think there's another one. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought.
Soon enough.
That's what happens when I get serious.
It's them!
Get out of our way. Hold still. I'll make this quick.
Who loves your baby? No way! No way! No way!
Let's go.
That's the logical outcome. I just keep getting stronger.
Now then, at least we don't have to worry about being shot at anymore.
We might have stopped the knights, but we still gotta deal with this guy. He's not a Hermes Blastia, but the formula's been encrypted.
Care to explain in English?
Basically, without a key to decode the formula, we can't turn it off.
So I assume breaking the code isn't...
No, it's not easy. Even if I could break it, that would take time. Maybe if I...
I don't think this will take much time at all.
Wait! But you said...
Help!
What are you doing here?
Perhaps he is this Blastia's engineer.
No, I mean, I am an engineer and all, but I was just following orders. I swear I never wanted to get involved in something like this.
Undo the code and stop this Blastia now!
Yes, of course, right away.
I'm sorry for surprising you back there.
Huh, duh. I knew right away you were only trying to make me jump.
Oh?
At least that's one problem down. Now we can go to Murzo once the weather clears.
No!
What is it?
Yuri!
I could use your help here, kid.
Right.
Should have known they'd have another one of these.
Yuri, don't tell me you did that to keep me from using my power.
Don't you think that was a bit reckless?
Indeed. Do you have a death wish?
This? This is nothing.
Yuri, I'm sorry. It was my fault.
Hey, you did the same for us before, right? Well, now we're even.
But...
Estelle, perhaps a simple thank you would do best.
I... Thank you.
Moving right along. We'd better do something about that other Blastia.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to know... Hey!
Fast, little bugger. We better catch him quick.
Please wait. Patty is... Rita, I'm sorry. I let him get away.
Don't worry about it. I'll come up with something.
Yeah, but you said it wasn't easy.
As long as the knights aren't around, we don't have to worry so much about how long it takes. Besides, who do you think you're dealing with? I'm the genius mage, Rita Mordio. If it's me versus a Blastia, I'll win or die trying.
Let's hope it doesn't come to that.
What are you doing? If we leave it like this, someone could use it again. I'll just make a few adjustments. I'm sorry.
Nothing shines quite so bright as a young person with something they're willing to risk their life for.
For somebody who stood on death's doorstep, saying you'll do something or die trying isn't just a figure of speech.
Huh? Death's doorstep?
Didn't you say you almost died during the Great War?
Huh. Forgot I mentioned that. Well, only the living have the privilege of saying they'll fight to the last breath. Words like conviction and resolve don't mean much to a dead man.
You okay, old man?
Here I am, running off at the mouth. I get a bit sentimental when I start digging up the past. Come on! Onward!
Ready to go?
You'll be gone soon enough. I'm just getting started.
I feel like there was a Giganto here before. I don't know, maybe that's later?
I guess we'll fight.
Maybe that's a different area I'm thinking of. Alright, gotta use it 10 more times. And that'll have to be good enough now. There we go. Alright, so we learned that. Now we learn the other one. Service glass. Hydro glass. Actually, we're gonna change this. Let's see. Alright. Oh, I forgot I had food. Oops. I could be good. Let's go up then. Oh, that didn't work.
Leave it to me.
Actually costs less TP than the normal move. I didn't realize that. Interesting. I can just use Helix Circle now. They're pretty much the same.
Take cover!
Is everyone okay?
I'll live.
Me too.
This time the old man looks a little worse for wear.
Hey old man, wanna sit this one out? We can go on ahead.
If you leave me behind, there ain't any place else for me to go.
Come on, even Yuri wouldn't leave you here for good. And anyway, you could always go back to Altos, couldn't you?
There's always that, I suppose. They're, how do I say it, not the same as you guys.
Oh, really?
Well, if you're okay, old man, let's get over to that Blastia before it recharges and attacks us again.
Aye, aye. Roger that.
Okay. I think I can go down this way.
Shining face! Ready for some yet!
That's what happens when I get serious.
I'll probably be able to learn it pretty soon. What do you mean, help me out here? You're the one with the recovery move, Carol. See, there you go.
The sign of victory! Yeah. Alright!
Hey, correct.
You'll be gone soon enough.
Raven? What was he doing for a second there? He's just sort of like spazzing out. He's such a sleepy few today, I don't know. Why are you?
Who's next?
This?
Get ready. I'm taking you down. We'll fight.
Shining Fang!
it's over. Yeah, I feel good.
Learning all the things. I think there is a Giganto here. I don't remember.
I guess we'll fight. Come here!
Oh, I forgot there was a fake ear. Nice.
I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna do it. Well, that was a pretty easy fake. Okay, I believe that was a Giganto I just saw.
Get ready. I'm taking you down. It's over.
I feel this power inside me.
This is a mistake to lie down. You don't want to get back up. Oof.
Leave it to me.
Shining face!
So, yeah, just stay dead.
Yeah, I feel good.
Okay, no, not yet. Okay, yeah, I was right. There was a Giganto here. This guy is pretty tough, if I remember correctly, so I'm probably gonna save first. Try to fight this thing. Which means, let's see. Want my healer. He's just chilling there. He's not harming anybody. He's just chilling, dude. But I'm gonna kill him anyways. Let's go. Alright, if I remember correctly, this guy's tough though, so. Oof, yeah, he's a high level. He's like twice my level.
Here. Not done yet.
Oh, I forgot to change their strategy again. Oops. I don't think he's taken a whole lot of damage so far. Yeah, I probably have to come back later and do this as soon as they're done. I wonder what's for dinner tomorrow. Yeah, I'm not gonna try to beat this fight.
And they were never heard from again.
Womp. Wrong way. Yeah, I forgot that guy's like twice my level right now.
Just getting started.
Agility should help him out. Ha, sniped him.
Prepare to meet your doom.
I'm just getting started.
Finish that one.
taking you down. Still, I'll make this quick.
I'm basically at this point gonna get to Muorzo and then probably end it there.
Let's eliminate them!
We're done. I'm taking you down.
Get out of here! Come on, of course, man. Didn't work.
Actually, I think I'm just gonna save the save point and stop. Because the noise has started.
Sorry, but you're going bye bye. So that's where I'm going to end it for today, but then I can come back here and do more stuff next time. So peace out, everyone.